Over the game's 6-year history, Fortnite has had a large amount of changes to its map. So many, in fact, that it feels like every time I want to play this bloody game, I have to install an update of 10 gigabytes. But as much as I might have enjoyed looking at an update screen, I mean playing all kinds of different maps, they all pale in comparison to the good old Fortnite map of 2017, when I was still young and oh my god, it's back! So, what better time to ask the question, what is the population of the real Fortnite? The current reincarnation of the OG map is from Season 5, when there were already quite some extra POIs added, like the Viking Village, Lucky Landing, and even Tilted Towers did not used to exist in the Season 1 map. But you will probably have noticed that there's not actually anybody living on the map. So, I will try to determine a realistic population that should and would be able to live in the Fortnite map, if it were an actually real inhabited land. To do this, I will count all the places people can live, mainly houses and apartments. Then take an average of how many people live there and multiply the two to get the population. Now I only have to answer the question of what country and what time period this map is based on. Well, for the country, I don't think that's much of a mystery. As for the time period, I think the point of the first chapter of Fortnite in general is to say fuck space and time and all logic in existence, enjoy this desert and a random cube. So I'm gonna just go with 2017 when the map was created. In that year, in America, there were 2.6 people per household. Now I'll start with some smaller towns and work my way up to Tilted Towers, which this time around is for once, thank god, not monstrously big. So let's for now start with the relatively small and quite diverse Paradise Palms. Cause next to counting the, in this case, 5 houses as secondary goal of this video, I'm also going to keep track of the other types of buildings that you can find throughout the map, like these shops, to see if there's a somewhat realistic amount of them in relation to the population. In total, in this town there are 3 shops. There's also a gas station, which I guess I could technically count as a store. There's also 5 houses, which should house around 13 people. And you can already see, this is not adding up. But the thing is, if we zoom out, these stores serve as more than just Paradise Palms. It serves the entire region, mainly this ungodly and unnamed town. At least I hope they serve them, cause there's literally nothing here except the most tiny little piece of shit houses in the entire game. And ignoring the fact that for some houses there's no way to get to the upstairs part of the house, I think there is supposed to be 11 houses, so enough for about 29 people, to live in this horrific amalgamation of garbage. Which, together with the other houses in the area, brings us back to Paradise Palms. Cause that means there's 16 people per shop. Keeping in mind, these shops are video game-like sized, people can shop in multiple stores, and some of these are just one-of-a-kind shops, like a car dealership. This amount might make sense. And then there's one thing left in Paradise Palms, this building. When I went inside, I immediately assumed this is an apartment building. It looks very personal, and I would have written it down as such, were it not for the explicit claim on the front that it is actually an hotel. Which I won't count, because people that go on vacations still have a home when they get back. So that means the total stays at 13 people. And now with that way of measuring the ratio of people to stores, I think Retail Row would be a great next candidate. Over here, there's also a grand total of 5 houses, 13 people, but 8? Yes, 8 stores. Well, I guess the name's not inaccurate, but that does mean there's almost one store for every person of working age. If we for fairness sake take into account the houses around there, like those in Salty Springs, which is, just consists of, again, 5 houses, 13 people, and a singular gas station, it still doesn't make sense, even if we count the trailer park as having housing units. And adding 17 houses, 44 people to the pile, we still get at most 10 people per store. So, no, it's probably not realistic. Now, if we keep on moving north, we'll end up at Tomato Town. This town, has seen better days. The town is so utterly destroyed, in fact, that there's only one singular house still standing. Yes, this is all that remains of the once prosperous, oh wait a second. Is that what Tomato Town looked like? Okay then, I guess the temple sprouting out of the ground might not have been the worst thing after all. And whilst they might be worshipping a literal tomato, Tomato Temple is one of the two towns that actually has some sort of house of worship. The other town is Lucky Landing, and ooh, they have quite a lot. If you count the temple just outside the town, there's three temples in total, which is coincidentally the same amount as there are shops and houses in the town. So that means every household can have their very own temple. This town is also special for having the only office building outside of Tilted Towers. Speaking of Tilted Towers, to precisely no one's surprise, this city is the biggest in-game. It's also the only city filled with, well, apartment towers. Although now that I'm looking at it, they're not tilted at all! You lied to me! Whilst I remember this town as being quite big, when I counted it, I was surprised to see that there were only 5 apartment buildings in the entire city, with a total of 22 apartments. There were 7 stores, on top of one of which was another apartment building, and whilst most of these buildings were pretty well designed, there was one apartment that stood out from the rest, as well a bit inefficient. This apartment, the only one that is truly tall, is not really an apartment building as much as it is a gigantic staircase with the occasional apartment attached. But this 50-50 functionality split seems very tame once we move over to the offices in this town. Specifically, this one. This is one of the, if not the biggest building in the entire city. And as can be seen on this sign, the building is currently used by an insurance company. I'll walk you through the building. At the bottom floor, of course, we have a parking lot. Then at the ground floor, there's room to meet and greet your clients, very wide and spacious. Then we have the employee kitchen for breaks. And if your employees are done with their break, they can take a break from their break in this break area. If you for whatever reason plan on shitting yourself, you're probably in a utopia, because there's 2 whole bathrooms. There's even this dusty, crusty old closet. Next to that, there's only one floor with 2 tiny office spaces for, I counted, 11 workers. And of course, one anxiety-generating boss to breathe down your neck at all times. So, efficiency. That's like 20% of the building is actually devoted to offices. So that makes for this map of Tilted. In total, the biggest city houses only 67 people. Now, this is the map so far, and whilst we've done quite some towns, there's still a few left, but they're mostly boring. Snobby Shores is just 5 houses, Pleasant Park has 7 and a gas station. Greasy Grove was a bit more diverse with 4 houses, 2 shops and 1 gas station. The Viking Village also has 4 houses and 2 things that I think are stables for like livestock. And one of those old-timey town halls that are meant for drinking a shit ton of beer. And of course a bunch of tiny clusters of buildings and a bunch of lonely houses spread throughout the map. Among those, there are a shit ton that looked like something I can only describe as a crack den that's been heavily molested by a hurricane. These buildings I did not count. This brings us to a total of 119 housing units, 26 stores, 8 gas stations, 5 buildings of worship, 3 or 4 factories, 2 garages and 1 building for getting drunk. This all came to a total population of 309 people. Accounting for inaccuracies, the fact it is possible to live in a hotel or a vacation park, and possible homelessness, I think an accurate range for the population of Fortnite would be somewhere around the 300 to 340 people. If you then take a look at the stores, in total that means there's 1 store for every 12 people. If you count the gas stations, there's 1 store for every 9 people, which is indeed not very realistic, not even for an island. I also didn't count the exact number of jobs there would be. All the stores, the office buildings, the factories and all that kind of crap counted together. But I think even if all the 309 people would work, there would still not be enough people to cover all the jobs. So, there we have it. Whilst it's not an extremely shocking amount, it's been quite fun to once again play Fortnite. Oh man, I played this game so much back in the day. Specifically in the first year. Basically only in the first year. Coming home from school and just grinding away on a battle pass. Doesn't even matter whether you play it alone or with friends. I found it to be fun either way. It's not very high, but I think it's in my top 10 of all time. Yeah, fucking amazing to play again. I hope you enjoyed this video as well. I originally meant this week to be a population video about GTA 4. I just couldn't resist this. Plus, GTA 4 is a shit ton of work. So hopefully I'll have enough time next week. We'll see. Either way, thanks for watching. Bye bye.